First, we will discuss active power. The active power can be computed as 1/2 of the total capacitance of the circuit, where the capacitance can be seen as roughly proportional to chip area. So larger chips will have more of this. The next factor is voltage square. This is the power supply voltage. The higher the power supply voltage, the higher the power is, and this relationship is quadratic. So doubling of the power supply voltage will actually quadruple the power. The next factor is clock frequency. This is the gigahertz number that you normally see on a processor specification. And finally, the alpha is the activity factor. Without this alpha, we are assuming that the processor is constantly switching every clock cycle all of its transistors. So alpha really says that, for example, only 10% of the processor's transistors are actually active in any given clock cycle. Now let's see what happens to power if after 2 years we reduce the size of the processor to 1/2 of what it was because of technology improvement. The new capacitance is 1/2 of what it was for one processor. However, because we want to build a more powerful processor, we put two of them on the chip, so the C new really is equal to C old. Let's say that the voltage and the frequency stay the same, and let's say that it's still the same processor design, so the same percentage of transistors are active. That means really that the active power is relatively unchanged if we do this. What we have is effectively a processor that consumes the same amount of power, but it does have twice the number of cores that it had before. So it's actually twice as capable computationally, because each of those cores is still operating at the same frequency as before, and it's really a very similar to the old core. In reality, smaller transistors are gonna be faster, so we can increase the clock frequency of the processor too. So let's say that the new clock frequency is 25% higher than the old one. That increases the power consumed. So it's now twice as fast because of the number of cores. Another 25% improvement because of this, but the overall power consumption is now higher. Smaller transistors, however, may let us lower the power supply voltage while maintaining the same speed. So let's say that the new power supply voltage is equal to 0.8 of the old power supply voltage. That allows us to have a significantly lower power consumption because of this square relationship. So 0.8 squared is 0.64. If we put these two together, we can get something like the voltage. We don't lower it as much, because if we did, then we couldn't also increase the frequency. So we lower it only a little bit. The frequency, we cannot increase it as much, because if we did, we would have to keep the same power supply voltage as before. So let's say we only increase the frequency by a factor of 1.1. If you now apply this equation, we get that the new power is about 90% of the old power. So what we got is now we have a chip that is having two cores instead of one. It has a lower power supply voltage but a higher frequency, so each of these cores is 10% faster than the one used to be, and yet we have lower power consumption. This is why it's so important for active power to have the technology improvement reduce the size of transistors. And we also have to realize that in order to get power improvements, we really, really, really need to lower the voltage.